is this is a class work, sir?
Wait. I'll tell.
Sir,
I'll tell.
I'm
Don't
used
stop
to
anything. I will tell.
sir.
You know, first listen the class, and then you can start writing anything. I will tell. I will give the time. You first listen the class carefully. Listening the class is very very important here. Without listening, you can't do anything. Writing class work is not very important. I give time for writing class work and all. So don't write urgently. Okay. First of all, listen. First 25 minutes. Listen what I'm teaching. Then you can go for the class work writing. Okay. Okay. So voltammeter is a device used to measure the distance traveled by an object. And another device is speedometer. So in your vehicles, we know that there are two types of meters will be there. One is indicating that how many kilometers are traveling. That reading will be there. And another one is there is a needle. The needle will show that how much speed you are going. The 60 kilometers speed, 40 kilometers speed will be there. So the measure, the speedometer is a device used to measure both speed and distance. Speed and distance. Both the speed and distance. Like, yeah. So this is called a speedometer. So difference between the odometer and the speedometer is odometer can measure only the distance. The speedometer can measure both the speed and the distance. So you can see in a TS50 or any vehicles or car, bus, anything, there will be a round meter will be there, and there will be readings will be there. 1, 2, 3, 4, I guess readings will be there. So this was the distance. This was the distance of an object. It will be moving there. It will be moving there. Yeah. Then there is a needle like this. There will be ready had. It will be like this. It shows 0, 10, 20, 40, 60. 80, 90, 100 will be there. And this will show this needle shows the speed of an bike, car, or bus, anything. Like you are. So the odometer is a device used to measure the distance of an vehicle, and speedometer is a device used to measure both speed and the distance. It's called as the speedometer. So can you understand what is the difference between odometer and speedometer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so this is distance also. So the odometer measuring distance, speedometer measuring speed and the distance. Okay, now let us go for a small problem. On the day I told you, that's I gave the introduction to the problem. Now we get to do the problem. So what is the question there? What is the question? Have you copied the question on the day of you in the class or not? Copy bonding law, question copy bonding law?
No, sir.
No. Okay.
Sir, question number one only we copied, sir.
Okay, question number two, I will say after this again, right? A farmer, farmer moves. I will show in the screen. Don't copy it now. Listen, all of you. Okay, a farmer moves along the boundary of a field like this. Okay, boundary of a field like this. It is a square. It is a square field. Okay, sorry. It's a square field. The side of his field is 10 meter. This is 10 meter. This is 10 meter. This is 10 meter. So this is 10 meter. So this is A. This is B. C and D can take like this. A, B, C can take like this. Okay, see here. The farmer takes to complete the 40. The total, what is total distance of the field now? Perimeter. What is perimeter? Perimeter is the outer. So total distance. 40 meters will be there. Yeah. The farmer took 40 seconds to cover the 40 meters. How many seconds? 40 seconds. Yes. So for 1 second, how much distance will travel for 1 second?
40 seconds.
For 1 second, how much distance will travel?
1 meter.
1 meter, yes. 40 by 40 is equal to 40 meter by 40 seconds is equal to 1 meter. Okay, 1 meter per second, 1 meter per second. So the farmer can tell 1 meter per second. Now the question is, what is the question now? At the end of 2 hours, that is 2 minutes, 20 seconds. 2 minutes, 20 seconds. That means how many seconds totally? 2 minutes, 20 seconds. How many seconds are there totally?
140 seconds,
sir. Totally 140 seconds. 140 seconds. The question is, at the end of 140 seconds, where will be the farmer? Farmer, பதங்கிற பாரு. So further you can calculate a small calculations. 1.5 seconds means this is A to D, this is one down. How much down? One down. A to B, one down. So for one down, it took 40 seconds. Okay. So for quarterly 140 seconds divided by 40 seconds, what will get? We get 3.5 rounds. Yes, total time taken by farmer is 140 seconds. For one down, he took 40 seconds. Okay. So if you take 140 by 40, we get 3.5 rounds. Yeah. So first round, 1, 2, first round this is A to D first round, A to A first round, and A to A second round, and A to A third round, and half round will be A to B and C. 3.5 rounds will be C. 3.5 rounds will be C. So, Prida. Yeah, so 140 seconds. So now I want to calculate the displacement. So what is the displacement? The shortest distance is called the displacement. So here if I take this diagonal, this is the shortest distance. This is the shortest distance here. Okay, this is the shortest distance. Okay, now, you know Pythagoras theorem, syllabary, okay, girl.
Sir, I know, sir.
Yes, you can tell. Yes, who knows that?
Sir, the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of
good.
Square of other two sides, sir.
Yes, very good, very good, very good. Fantastic. So, the sum of the hypotenuse side, is the sum of the sides, square of the sides. I know sum of the sides of the squares. So, I can take here. So, we already know that there is 10 meters, 10 meters. So, I want to find only the hypotenuse. But find only the hypotenuse. Okay. Okay, now see here. I want to find the displacement. AC is equal to AC. This is called AC, no? AC is equal to root of, yeah, root of 10 square.
Sir, your board is so blurred.
Sir, your screen is blurred, sir.
Sir, blur, we cannot see.
Not clear, sir. Your voice is also breaking, sir.
Voice is also breaking, yeah. Voice, there is no clear.
Yes, sir, now it is clear, sir.
Okay, it's clear. Okay. So, see here. So, this is hypotenuse. This is hypotenuse AC. So, sum of the sides AD plus DC, we can take any two sides because it is hypotenuse and it is a square field. So, AC is equal to root of 10 square plus 10 square. Root of 10 square plus 10 square. What is the answer here? 100 plus 100 over ma is equal to root of 200.
14.14
meters. So the distance, the displacement is equal to 14.14 meters. Okay. Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Clear now? Yeah, after clear now? Clearer ka?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So another thing I'll tell afterwards, you can go for the classwork. You can copy the classwork letter. Okay, now you are traveling in a straight line. So there is no traffic in the road. Everything is clear. Only you are traveling the car. Suppose you're going to from a school to Madurai. But in his disturbance. You are the car traveling. You are 40 kilometers per hour. Suppose it take for first 10 minutes, it going for 10 kilometers, or 10 kilometers, and for next 10 minutes, it going 10 kilometers like that. It goes in equal intervals of time. Yeah. So it covers
same distance
in the same equal intervals of time. It is called as the uniform motion. Uniform motion. First of all, see, if you take this, the car is traveling in a straight line motion. Yeah, straight line motion for first 10 minutes. It covers 10 kilometers. So next 10 minutes, it covers another 10 kilometers. Yeah, and next 10 minutes, it covers another 10 kilometers. So it travels with a uniform speed, travels with a uniform. Same distance it is traveling. Okay. Same distance it is traveling in the same time. So time given is 10 minutes. Okay, distance traveled first 10 minutes it travels 10 kilometers and second 10 minutes it travels second 10 kilometers. So it is equal. The time and distance are equal. So if an object covers equal distance, equal intervals, like it is called as the why Umma Maheshwari left. Yeah. So if a car travels in equal distance in a given time, it is called as the uniform motion. It is called as the uniform motion. If an object travels equal distance in a equal interval of time. It is called as the uniform motion. Suppose take an example. If you are traveling in a crowded place, can you go in the same distance? Suppose you are going from school to Madurai, you are going in a same street to Madurai. But if that is a town area or crowded place, can you travel in the same manner? Can you calculate the same distance in same time?
No, sir.
That will be different, no? So if it is a crowded place, you will take event 50 minutes. If it can take 50 minutes or 20 minutes to cover the distance. So the distance will not be equal. Distance will not be equal in the given time. Yeah. So if an object takes unequal time, covers unequal distance in the equal interval of time. Yeah. Time is same. Time is given the same 10 minutes, but it covers the unequal distances. It is not covering the same distance, so it is called as a non-uniform motions. Okay, so now we are going to two types of motions. One is uniform motion and the non-uniform motion. Uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So uniform motion in the sense, if an object covers equal distance in the equal interval of time, equal distance in equal interval of time is called as the uniform motion. The object covers unequal distance in the equal interval of time. Same time though, but distance matter more. Okay, if an object covers the unequal distance in the equal interval of time, it is called as the non-uniform motion. It is called as the non-uniform motion. What motion?
Non-uniform
motion.
Sir, good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. So, you are seeing two types of motions. One is uniform motion and the non-uniform motions. Okay, so what difference between the uniform and non-uniform motion means, if an object travels object travels equal interval of time in the equal distance in the equal interval of time, it is called as the uniform motion. If object covers unequal distance in the equal interval of time, it is called as the non-uniform motion. So these are the two
sir, variations. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, yeah.
சார் ஒரே 1 மினிட் சார் பா எல்லாமே சுவிட்ச் அந்த வீடியோ டிய வீடியோ ஆன் பண்ணுங்க
ஆன் பண்ணுங்க ஆஃப் பண்ணீங்க ஓய் ஆன் பண்ணுங்க
थैंक यू சார்
ஓகே ஓகே புரியதா சோ புரியதா இப்ப சோ இஃப் an ஆப்ஜெக்ட் covers equal distance in the equal interval time, that is called as the uniform motion. I write in the board just this and that. What is uniform motion? Uniform motion. The object covers equal distance. Distance in equal time, in equal interval of interval means that is gap interval of time, equal interval of time. It is called as the uniform motion. Then non-uniform motion sense, non-uniform motion, same time will be given, but it covers the unequal distance. Non-uniform motion, if the object covers unequal distance. Here paranga equal distance, here unequal distance in equal, who is singing a song there, equal intervals of time.
Sir, we have to write this in classwork, sir.
No, just listen. I will say then only you get the copy. Then listen the class. Listening is very important. Governing a class, sir. அப்புறம் எழுதலாம். எழுதுறது முக்கியமே கிடையாது. நான் சொல்றப்ப எதுனா போதும். Yeah. So, uniform motion, non-uniform motions. There are two types of motions you have seen now. So, the object covers equal distance in equal interval time. For non-uniform motion, the object covers unequal distance in equal interval time. Example புரியுதா? எப்படி அந்த suppose you take going straight road. இங்க இருந்து ஸ்ட்ரைட்டா போயிட்டே இருக்க. You are going to cover 70 கிலோமீட்டர்ஸ் ஓகேவா 70 கிலோமீட்ஸ் போயிட்டே இருக்கு இல்லையா ஸோ இங்கேருந்து போயிட்டே இருக்கு இப்போ வந்து நீ மதுரைக்கு போயிட்டேன் மதுரைக்கு வந்து சொன்ன மாதிரியா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் 10 மினிட்ஸ் 40 மினிட்ஸ் செகண்ட் போயிட்டு இருக்கேன் ஓகே நான் ஓகே வாட் ஸ்பீடாக இருக்கு கோயிங் ஹவு கேன் கால் கேட் தி ஸ்பீட் யூஆர் கிவன் டூ சிச்சுவேஷன்ஸ் ஒன் இஸ் யூஆர் கோயிங் இன் ஏ ஸ்ட்ரைட் லைன் வித்வுட் எனி டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் இந்த அனதர் ஒன் இஸ் யூ கிவன் வி ஆர் கோயிங் வித் டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் தெர் இஸ் எ டிராஃபிக் ஜாம்ஸ் வில் பி தேர் ஸோ தேர் ஆல்சோ சம் டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் யூ ஆர் ட்ராவலிங் இன் தி சேம் டைம் ஓகேயா இந்த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கேஸ் யூ ஆர் ரீச்சிங் தி மதுரை இன் 4 hours ஓகேயா டேக் டிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி மதுரை இஸ் 200 kilometers அப்ராக்சிமேட் 200 kilometers ஸோ ஃபார் பெர் அவர் யூ ஆர் ட்ராவலிங் 40 kilometers ஸோ டோட்டலி யூ டேக் 5 kilometers பெர் ஹவர் யூ கோயிங் வித்வுட் எனி டிஸ்டர்பன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் ஸ்ட்ரைட் லைன் யூ ஆர் டேக்கிங் 5 hours சப்போஸ் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் இன் தி க்ரௌடட் பிளேசஸ் ஆர் தி டிராஃபிக் ஜாம்ஸ் கேன் யூ ரீச் தி மதுரை இன் சேம் டைம் போயிருப்ப
Distance traveled by time taken is called as the speed.
Using the formula, distance traveled by time taken. This is the formula. So in the first case, you can easily calculate. In the second case, we are going sometimes we are going very slow, sometimes we are going very fast. Okay. Then in that case, how can you calculate the distance speed? sometimes you are going slow, sometimes you are going very fastly. Was Ashwin Balaji? Ashwin Balaji? Sometimes you are going slow, sometimes you are going fast. How can you calculate the speed in this situation?
Sir, the total distance by time taken, sir.
Yes, it, in this case, we can take as average speed. You can take as the average speed is equal to total distance traveled by the time taken. So both are same only. Speed is equal to average speed, both are same only.
Yes,
so totally, we are going to calculate the speed using the formula. It's the total distance traveled by time taken. Total time taken. Total time taken. Suppose now, you can calculate the speed now. Now, I told that what is the distance to Madurai?
Sir, 200 kilometers.
So, what is the time taken to reach Madurai from the first case?
So, five hours.
Now, 200 divided by 5, what is the answer?
Sir, 40.
Sir, 40.
So, averagely,
40
kilometers per hour, you are traveling there. You know, for 1 hour, you are traveling 40 kilometers per hour.
40
kilometers. 40 kilometers. How many kilometers? 40 kilometers. 40 kilometers. So, in the case of second case, in the case of second case, the total distance covered by is 6 hours. Now calculate the speed of the car. What is the answer? Two hundred kilometers I told total distance to Madurai, and same case 6 hours. It took. Yeah. 6 hours. Now, what is the speed now? Calculate it. 3, 6
sir,
hours. 3, 6 are 18, then 20. 3, 6 are 18. 20 is going like this. 3.3. So, averagely, it took 33 kilometers per hour. In first case, 40 kilometers per hour. Second case, approximately 33 kilometers per hour travel. How much distance? 33 hours is travel. So, total distance, whatever. You want to calculate the speed means, what is the formula now? What is the formula for speed?
Total distance traveled.
Total distance taken by
total distance taken by traveled by divided by total time taken.
Taken by time taken. Total distance by time taken. So without speed meter, you can calculate now, no?
Yes, sir.
You know the distance and you know the time taken, you can calculate the speed. This is the formula. Using this formula only, we have invented the speedometer. Okay, sir. So, speed is equal to total distance by time taken.
Yes, sir.
Then what is the
SI
unit of speed?
meter per second or kilometer per hour.
Is on the SI unit. Small is the small units, is the bigger units. Kilometer hour is the bigger unit, and meter per second, centimeter per second is the lesser unit, small unit.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Three SI unit we can ask, sir.
What, pa?
Sir, in this
meter per second or centimeter per second. Meter பண்ண முடியாது, கிலோமீட்டர் பண்ண முடியாது, சென்டிமீட்டர் பண்ண
முடியுமா?
இவ்வளவு டிஸ்டன்ஸ் இருக்கு, எடுத்துக்கலாம். ஒரு மீட்டர் மேல போச்சு, மீட்டர் எடுத்துக்கலாம். சோ கிலோமீட்டர் 5 kilometers மேல போனா கேன் யூஸ் 6 kilometers. இங்கே கிலோமீட்டர் எடுத்துக்கலாம், பட் கிலோமீட்டர் கம் இன் டெசிமல்ஸ்ல வரும். சோ டெசிமல்ஸ் வந்து நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணது ரொம்ப கஷ்டமா இருக்கும். சோ வந்து ஸ்மால் மீட்டர் எடுத்துக்கலாம், சென்டிமீட்டர் எடுத்துக்கலாம். லார்ஜ் மீட்டர் லாங் தான் போகும்போது இட் டேக்ஸ் 6 kilometers எடுத்துக்கலாம். ஓகே, புரியுதா?
ஓகே சார். ஓகே சார்.
So, yes, sir. Seconds and centimeters. Meter per second, கிலோமீட்டர் பிற ஒரு ஹவருக்கு எத்தனை கிலோமீட்டர் போயிருக்கு, அதான் வந்து அதான் வந்து அவர் இதான் வந்து ஆவரேஜ். ஓகேவா? ஓகே லட்சிதா?
எஸ் சார்.
ம், ஓகே. எனி டவுட் இன் திஸ்? எஸ்
நோ சார்.
நோ டவுட். நோ வி கேன் கோ ஃபார் தி கிளாஸ் லைக் நோ. நோ வி கேன் கோ ஃபார் தி கிளாஸ். ஐ டேக் யுவர் கிளாஸ் லைக் நோ.
எஸ் சார்.